Bishop, something near and dear to my heart this day, seeing Andrew Kim, Taegon, and Paul Chong Hasang and the companions. There's a vivid story of their martyrdom in the Liturgy of the Hours, in the Office of Readings. And every year when I read that, I think about the powerful imagery. First of all, their death was horrific, but secondly, how other people were called to faith by their suffering.
It's so true. And the other thing, too, in terms of the evangelization of Korea, it was lay-led. They were anticipating, in a certain sense, the councils, Second Vatican Council's apostolate of laity. And the contemporary Church of Korean Catholics draws on these martyrs. It's like it's just a very living relationship. And the canonization homily of St. John Paul II in 1984, I think, captures the charism so beautifully. St. John Paul II writes, "The Korean martyrs have borne witness to the crucified and risen Christ through the sacrifice of their own lives. They have become like Christ in a very special way. The words of St. Paul the Apostle could truly have been spoken by them. We are always carrying the body, the death of Jesus, so that the life of Jesus may also be manifested in our bodies. We are always given up to death for Jesus' sake, so that the life of Jesus may be manifested in our mortal flesh." Saints Andrew Kim Taegon and Paul Chong Hasang and companions, pray for us.